Good day, students, and welcome to your office administration class. I am your teacher, Mr. Heron. Today we're going to be looking at the types of office equipment. Our objective for this class is the purpose of office equipment. All right, now before we begin, just a disclaimer. The list that we're going to be going through is not a comprehensive list of all the equipment that will be found in any specific or any particular office. The equipment found in a particular office will be selected based on the office's specific need. All right, so let's get right into it. Now, equipment found in modern offices are expensive and use considerable amount of electric energy. As such, they should be chosen carefully to ensure that they contribute as much as possible to the efficiency of the company. So, when selecting equipment for an office, you may want to think about things like, is it energy efficient? All right? Now, in addition, users of the equipment should be fully trained and aware of the capabilities, features, speed, and how to care for these equipment. All right, now we're going to be looking at some of these equipment. All right, so let's go through the list. Guillotine, shredder, photocopier, risograph, scanner, printers, facsimile, yes, that's the correct pronunciation, computers, multimedia, and specifically we're going to be looking at the digital camera and the LCD projector, laminating machines, binding machines, and labeling machines. So the first equipment we're going to be looking at is the guillotine. Now the guillotine is your standard paper cutter. Now I know you may be wondering, why do we need a guillotine? We can use a scissors. Now the truth is, a guillotine is way more effective in making precise straight cuts, right? So if you need something to be cut or asymmetric, meaning perfectly straight lines, your guillotine is your best option. All right, some things to look for when selecting a guillotine is are the amount of paper that can be stacked and cut. All right, next we're going to be looking at the shredder. All right, now the shredder is a very useful equipment in the office. Files that are taking up space can be destroyed using a shredder. Now, information that are sensitive in nature need to be properly discarded to prevent them from getting into the hands of the wrong person. So, information that is sensitive, that is no longer needed, need to be properly discarded. The shredder is an excellent option because it cuts paper in thin shreds, making it near impossible to be reassembled and to decipher. All right? The next equipment we're going to be looking at is the photocopier. All right? So photocopiers are used to make multiple copies of the same document. They are indispensable in medium and large businesses where multiple copies of documents are needed. Photocopiers are much faster than printers, right? There are photocopiers that are able to print in color, and there are some photocopiers that can be connected directly to a computer and can serve as a scanner or a printer. Now, all photocopiers are not made the same. Yeah, that's true. Now, there are some photocopiers that can do much more than simply copying documents. There are some photocopiers that you can stack papers at the top in a feeder, and they will make multiple copies of that stack. In addition, there are some photocopiers that give you the option of stapling those stacks, right? So photocopiers, they come in different ranges in prices and functionality, all right? Next, we're going to be looking at the risograph. Now, the risograph is very similar to a photocopier with a key distinction. The risograph is specially designed to handle high volumes of copying, right? So a risograph is similar to a photocopier in its design. It is designed to handle high volume of copying, when hundreds or even thousands of copies are needed. A standard risograph can print an average of 130 pages per minute. All right? The next equipment we're going to be looking at is the scanner. A scanner is a device that takes a picture of an optical image or text and converts it into digital images. The document is placed on a glass window for scanning. All right, now, there are some scanners that come in what's called a combo or a package, where it's able to scan, it can print, it can also photocopy. All right? We're going to be looking now at printers, and we have different types of printers, right? So let's talk about what a printer is. Printers are output devices that is used in the office to create text and graphic records relevant to the business. They work in combination with a computer. All right, we're going to be looking at some of the different types of printers. And the first one is the dot matrix or an impact printer. All right. Now, the dot matrix printer are impact printers that generate poor quality documents. They do so cheaply and are typically used for printing data that does not need to be presented well. Now, items such as, or documents such as invoices that don't require much presentation per se, the dot matrix printer would be an ideal solution because it's inexpensive and the information that is being presented does not need to be well presented. All right? The next printer we're going to be looking at is the plotter. All right? These printers are often used in creating tactile images for the visually impaired on special types of paper. So we think about Braille, right? The plotter would be a printer that can handle such a job. Next, we're going to be looking at the inkjet printer. All right? The inkjet printer generates good quality prints of all kinds and are relatively inexpensive. The replacement cartridges, on the other hand, can be relatively expensive depending on the volume of printing needed, right? So the inkjet printer will give you a much better quality than the dot matrix printer. Next, we're going to be looking at the laser printer, all right? The laser printer is the most expensive printer used in most modern offices because it produces the best quality and the sharpest prints. All right, so in instances where you need an output, a print or a document with very high quality, sharp, your laser printer is going to be your best option. Okay? Now we're going to be talking about the computer. Now, the computer is at the heart of the functioning of most business. This is because they perform very useful functions in a systematic way, which help the business to operate in a more efficient manner. So, I'm willing to bet that in almost every business that you come across, there is a computer involved, all right? Because the computer is able to perform a wide array of functions, and it also helps the business to operate in a much more effective manner. All right? So we have different types of computers. We're going to be looking at the desktop computer now. All right? And also the laptop computer. Now, the desktop computer as the name suggests, it sits on a desk. It has a monitor, a central processing unit, keyboard, mouse, and in some cases, it's attached to a printer, right? Now, some of the things that you look for when you are buying a computer is, of course, the amount of storage space or the storage capacity of the computer, all right? You want to think about things like its processor, how quickly can it process data or information, all right? And also, price may be a factor that you want to consider when choosing a computer. Now, the laptop computer is a much more condensed or portable option to a computer, which will give you pretty much all the same functions in a more compact package. So you can fold it up, stick it in a bag, and you're on the go, right? Now let's look at the multimedia devices. Now, a multimedia device combines more than one form of media, such as text, graphic, video, animation, and sound in a desired way. A computer, mouse, on-screen buttons, or text entry allow you to make decisions as to what takes place next using a multimedia device. All right? So the first multimedia device we're going to be looking at is the digital camera. The digital camera is a device that is used to capture pictures, right? Now, once these pictures are taken, there are several options that you have in storing or printing the captured picture. The images can be stored on a flash card or a disk. You put in your computer, and you have the option of printing that on your printer or in some cases your photocopier machine that can handle printing jobs. All right, the next multimedia device we're going to be looking at is the LCD projector. Now, LCD projector simply stands for liquid crystal display. All right, now you are seeing this, the images on the screen with the aid of an LCD projector. Right, and what it does, it takes whatever's on your computer or your laptop, and in a much bigger format, it's displayed on a whiteboard or a screen. Right, so your LCD projector takes your standard desktop or laptop and make the screen that much bigger. All right, so in the event you're having a presentation for thousands of persons, you can project your computer screen on a whiteboard for everyone to see with the help of an LCD projector. All right, the next equipment we're going to be looking at is the facsimile machine, also known as a fax machine. All right, the fax machine allows you to transmit and receive the exact copy of a document to and from machines using a standard phone line. The fax machine is given a specific telephone number, which is called the fax number. The fax machine is usually kept switched on to receive documents at any time. So most businesses will have a designated phone line for the fax machine, and that number is called the fax number. So potential customers or whoever wants to communicate with the office can send a document using the fax machine. Now, what most companies do is to have the fax machine switched on at all times, so it's never turned off. So what they do is periodically they will check the fax machine to see if there's any documents that were faxed to the number. All right, so if, let's say, a potential customer wants to send an invoice or whatever they want to send, at whatever time, they simply send that document, and when the office is open, the clerk or the employee will just go and check the machine and see if there's any documents. All right, so the next equipment we're going to be looking at is the laminating machine. A laminating machine is a device that seals a document in a transparent plastic covering. Now, documents that need to be preserved for an extended period, such as company certificates, license, identification cards, can be preserved using a laminating machine. Now, laminating documents will pretty much preserve the document for the lifetime of the business. All right, so it makes the document that much more durable. All right, now, some things to consider when purchasing a laminating machine is how fast it laminates a document, all right? Because it uses heat, so it takes some time for the machine to get warmed up. So these are some features that you want to think about when thinking to buy or purchase a laminating machine. The next equipment we're going to be looking at is the binding machine. Now, large businesses have regular meetings, board meetings, etc. Now, having documents or reports binded gives it a professional look, all right? In addition, let's say we have a potential customer that wants information about the company, and provided that the document is of such that it needs to be binded, having it professionally binded will make a lasting first impression, all right? So a binding machine is definitely a must-have in your arsenal of business equipment, all right? The next machine we're gonna be looking at, or the next equipment we're gonna be looking at, is the labeling machine. Now, you may ask, why would a company need a labeling machine? Now, when you think about storage of files, right? It's worth the investment having a labeling machine because, let's face it, not everyone's penmanship is up to par, all right? So having documents professionally labeled can eliminate the guesswork in trying to figure out who wrote this, what is that? It eliminates all the guesswork. So having documents and equipment around the office professionally labeled, it makes that much of a difference, all right? So there you have it, students. A list of equipment found in modern offices. Now, let me reiterate. The list that was covered here just now is not a comprehensive list of all the equipment found in all offices. The nature of an office will dictate the different equipment that are needed. All right, so thanks for joining. I hope you learned something.